without question the most beautiful and evocative piece of machinery I've ever seen in my life, the Flying Scotsman. Superb. And this was one of the stars, was it not, of that race to the north?
Oh, absolutely, yes. I mean, this is the northeast answer to the triumph of the northwest. It was built in 1923 at Doncaster. It's part of the very early days of the London Northeastern Railway. And it's rather a complicated story, because there's two things called Flying Scotsman. There's a train, which is at 10 a.m. from King's Cross to Edinburgh, which is known as the Flying Scotsman train. And then there is this one, 4472, which is the locomotive called Flying Scotsman. And I suppose it's about the most famous name of any engine in the whole world, this one.
What weight is it?
It's the best part of 60 or 80 tons of stuff there all together. You take the sort of whole load of it, and it's coal and 5,000 gallons of water there in the back and 10 tons of coal up on the top there. It mounts up pretty substantially.
And how fast could this do the trip?
Well, basically those days it was about sort of 6.5, 7 hours running. I mean, that isn't much by modern standards, but in its day, in the 1930s, when you consider that the trip from London to Scotland, for example, in the First World War was averaging 12 and a half hours, it was a full sort of half of what it had been only a matter of 10 or 15 years before.
This had a spell in the States, didn't it, when its working life was over?
Yes,
not a happy one.
Not a happy one, no, no. Its original owner was bought sort of quite privately, this, by Alan Pegler, and he took it to America, and he just simply, I think, forgot how far places are apart in America, and he also forgot the fact that the whole railway system was completely run down, and costs piled up and so on. We nearly lost it, actually. You know, it was literally sort of lifted off a dockyard in Los Angeles at 5 o'clock in the morning as the broker's men were closing in on it to take it over, and they very much wanted to keep it in America, and it was in fact Bill McAlpine who scooped it up in one of his ships and got it back here, and that's why it's back here at Cotton Falls.
And is it hauling passengers here?
Oh, yes, yes, it does runs regularly, and it'll be out on the road with these special trains this summer, and it does a special run round through York and Harrogate and so on. It's an absolutely, totally working engine, as it was when it first came in 1923 at Doncaster.
What were the great names among its